My name is Jean-Pierre Barral, so I'm showing some techniques, some new approach of the joint. So why is a new articular approach? It's because we try to take care about all what is around the joint. It could be the capsule, synovial, labrum, active muscle, passive muscle, nerve, arteries. We'll see visceral connection and emotional connection. So it's important for us to check all the components of the joint. You know that if you just work on one part of the joint, it's not enough. And when you work on all the components, the results are lasting longer. Even if we are a little symptomatic. Of course, if you have a shoulder problem, for instance, this shoulder problem can come from the liver or some hormonal disbalance. But the problem, you cannot move no more your shoulder. And we must be symptomatic in order to help the patient to have a good mobility of the shoulder. So we don't forget that in our job, we try first to check the cause. It's very good to have the course, because during a course you can see a little the technique. But when we see, you can see this technique on a DVD, for instance, it's important because it's good for your memory. The problem of the shoulder, on the joint, any kind of joint, they need a negative pressure. You know, inside the joint, you must have a negative pressure in order to protect the cartilage, the labrum, and the capsule. Each time you have a tension of a soft part of the, like ligament, like muscle, or sometimes also some cartilage problem, the pressure of the joint increases. The circulation of the joint is bad, and often you will have some cartilage destroyed after a certain time. When we work on the joint, we try to restore the infra-atmospheric pressure so important for the joint. Also, we will see some technique very precise because we try to connect the Golgi tendon receptors. Everybody can move a joint. The problem is to be very, very precise. For instance, if I take the example of the hip or the example of the shoulder, there are 18 muscles. These 18 muscles are very precise receptors, mechanoreceptors. So the problem for us is not just to stretch the muscle, but to speak to the mechanoreceptors in order to have some general answer coming from the cerebellum and the spine. So don't forget, we are not speaking about mobility, we are not speaking about stretching, but speaking of something very precise, and it's so wonderful when you can help a patient. We take care about people with some pain. They cannot move so much. So we will show some very precise technique with short movement, but very precise, in order that if somebody, for instance, with a periarthritis of the shoulder, can do it by himself without hurting his shoulder. The patient can control everything. Wants to do 40 degrees. In a very short time, the patient will resist. And also, in this kind of technique, we speak about the mechanoreceptors. Suppose that at the beginning of the session, we create a pain to the shoulder, you will frozen all the mechanoreceptors. Your cerebellum, for instance, will receive more negative message, and your session will be not very effective. That is very important to respect the pain of the patient. We'll take care about all the elements of the joint. Could be labrum, it could be capsule, synovial, cartilage, ligaments, muscles, and also nervous system, vascular system, emotional connection, and visceral connection. For instance, for the shoulder, the right shoulder, liver is very important. We have many problems with the right shoulder. when the liver doesn't work very, very well. For the left shoulder, for instance, is connected with the heart and connected with the stomach. Sometimes when it's a little more difficult with the pancreas. So that kind of connection is important if you want to get good result to do some visceral manipulation in order to help the joint. And what is important is the concept, is the spirit of what you want to show you. The spirit is very short level, precise, speak to the brain through the joint. And that is very important for us to have this kind of feedback connection, in retroaction connection. After, a joint must have a negative pressure. You know, if you take a joint, there is a negative pressure permitting to the cartilage not to be irritated and to be very smooth. If you have a tension of the muscle, for instance, on the hip, on the shoulder, we have 18 muscles. On a little tension, this muscle is able to change the inside pressure of the joint. And when you change the inside pressure of the joint, if the pressure is more positive, you will have some problem with the venous system, arterial system, nervous system, and after the cartilage, which is not, we have no nerve, no arteries, but which should be erased. So, our techniques are symptomatic. Of course, when somebody has a pain on the shoulder, for instance, or on the elbow, what we try to do is to release this pain, even if the pain comes from another part of the body. Because, you know, we never forget that something else can give the tension of the shoulder and the elbow, but in a certain way your patient comes because it cannot move, and we must help this patient to move. So we are symptomatic, but without forgetting that we must think about the general position of the body, the general tension of the body, and also the projection, visceral projection and emotional connection. So it's a nice job, and you know what's the best, that we can help the patient and with lastable results. I was self a little disappointed at the beginning of my career because of this lack of lastable results. And thanks to that kind of technique, the patient will be better, and that is our goal, to help the patient.